On the narrow gauge line, Peter Sam had a dream. A dream of destiny. A dream of desire. And a dream of a dream. Where am I? Said Peter Sam. But no one, not even his driver and fireman, said a word. He was all alone. He popped past a very familiar face. It was the old Mid Sodor line. At its heyday, the cows were grazing. The school bells were ringing.
Holy shit, said the bridge. Holy fuck, said the grass.
Then he had to stop for water. The water at the old mine lid was just terrific. His safety gauge was saying, yes, fill me up. Then the driver appeared. We are almost here. What do you mean? Said Peter Sam. But then he could see a distant signal showing red. But then it happened. The signal arm rose to green, and then he was teleported.
I'm on my old home, said Peter Sam. This is amazing.
But then he had a deep suspicion.
Oh no, what about the others?
Then Peter Sam popped to the old shed where they used to sleep. Then his driver and fireman and Peter Sam saw to his horror what they saw. He saw himself when he was Stuart, but in the place where Smudger used to be, he was turned into a pumping engine, scared and terrified. Peter Sam saw his old counterpart and screamed in terror.
Ah, said Peter Sam. Ah, must have been another daydream. Are you all right?
Yes, are you? Smudger understood, and so did Stanley. They knew what was going on. Even the Flying Scotsman.
Oh, dear. A lot of terror happened. Oh, especially those terror cons that we had to deal with back in the summer. Whew, they were menacing. Well, I must be off. London awaits. Express coming through.
And soon, the coaches twittered, the guard blew their whistle, and Flying Scotsman made his way back to London. Peter Sam was thankful that his dream or nightmare wasn't a reality. However, there was some unfinished business that had to be dealt with, and some holiday specials amongst the stars and such. But that is a story for another day.